the rain started to fall on that car. Cooled it down. So we got to the top, it stopped. We go down the mountainside, go to go up the main, it started to rain on us again. That cloud followed. You say that's too hard. No, that's what the children of Israel experienced. You say, is there anything too hard for God?
No.
But there is a realm, there's a dimension, church, that God wants us to get into. He wants us to walk in. The answer is what Jesus said, is this. That the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things. Bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I said unto you. See, John was in the Spirit on the Lord's day when he heard a voice from heaven. This is what it said. I thou and meek, I'm the beginning and the end, and I live forevermore. This morning he's still alive and well. He is looking for a people who will not lean on their own understanding, but in all of our ways will acknowledge him. He shall direct our paths. I want to assure you this morning that God loves you, cares for you, concerned about you, and he wants to lead his dear children along. This morning is true. It's truer now than it's ever been. I believe we're on the brink of something happening. And you say, well, in the natural. I can't deal with the natural. If I deal with the natural, I wouldn't even be here. But I've got to deal with the supernatural. And I got to believe that God is about to open the windows of heaven upon this house, and they're about to come as Paul prayed from the north, the south, and the east and the west. I believe that something is about to break loose. The dam's about to break loose. I believe there's a lot of demons that have been putting their fingers in the hole and trying to plug it up, but I believe it's about to come over the top just like the Hoover Dam. And I believe that thing's about to explode. God's about to lose. We are not warring today against flesh and blood. We're fighting against the diabolical foe who's assigned against each one of us. And we got to understand that we're not in a battle, we're in a winner's circle. We have been assigned victory. We are more than conquerors. And the devil is afraid of us looking in the spirit and seeing him defeated and us being victorious. That's what he's afraid of. He wants us to look at the problems, the confrontations, the dilemmas, the discouragement, all of this stuff, instead of looking above it to our destiny, our purpose, our calling, and what God's about to do. I encourage you this morning, don't look at where you're at. Look at where you're going. Don't look at where you're at. Look at where you're going. God's got an assignment on your life. He'll take you through. No matter what you're in right now, he's about to take you through. This word's for you today. It's a good word, and I know it's for you. You stand with me. This morning you're here. You're going through something in your life. I want to declare to you, victory is your right. You've got sin in your life, just repent of it. Say, Father, forgive me of my sin. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I just give up today. You can't fight the devils of hell. You might think that you can. Put anything in your heart against anybody, just say, Lord, I'm sorry. I got to be right with you, got to be right with him. The thing is, it's not who's right, it's that you're right with him, that you're walking right. There will be a lot of voices in the days and weeks and months and years to come, as there's been in yesterday's. But you need to say, you know what? I want to turn into a frequency of heaven. I'll listen to the voice of the Spirit. And the voice of the Spirit says, listen, you've got an ear to hear what I got to say. I got some things to say of encouragement for you. Deliverance and freedom and victory is your right today. If you do something for me, no matter what you're going through, no matter if you're visiting or not, it's immaterial. It's a Bible truth. If you lift holy hands without wrath or devil, say, Lord, I just give you my life. I give you the situations I'm in. Some of the struggles that I can't control any longer, I give up. I give you today my life. I give you everything. Lord, take the heaviness off of folks today. Just take it off them. Lord, there's stuff that people can't take it. Just take it off them today, Lord. Just take it off them. Take it off of marriages, not my kids. Take it off of finances, Lord. Just take it off them today. Take the burden. Just let it roll off today in the name of Jesus. Lord, open their eyes that they might see that victory is rightfully theirs today. I declare it to men and women and homes all over this room. We declare it to prodigal sons and daughters. We declare it, Lord, in the name of Jesus, no matter what it looks like, that victory belongs to us in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Victory is rightfully ours. Hallelujah. You know the old chorus, victory, victory, it's mine. You know that chorus? Sing.
Victory, victory, it is mine. Victory, victory, it is mine. If I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battle. Victory, victory, it is mine.
Oh, yeah, come on, say it.
Oh, victory, victory, it is mine. Victory, victory, it is mine. If I hold my peace, let the Lord fight my battle.
Body, I want you just to place your hand on your body, your chest. Your head. We're going to sing it again. I want to declare to you that healing is yours this morning. They've been going through. Some folks in here, they need not a touch, they needed deliverance. They need to be healed by the power of Almighty God. So we're going to sing it again. I declare to you to be healed in the name of Jesus. It's your right. Come on.